man believed to be responsible for multiple stranglings in East Texas is finally in custody tonight. Authorities followed a tip that led them to a deserted motel outside Bryan, where they caught the man in the act of subduing 36-year-old Kelsey Keough. The man, whose name is being withheld, claimed he and Kelsey were participating in an agreed-upon way, and that he had no connections to the murders that have plagued the eastern part of the state since last June. Authorities were alerted to Hellum's ranch yesterday to investigate reports of cattle abuse, but what they found instead was disturbingly serene. The ranch was devoid of livestock. Instead, 13 men, all dressed in plain white clothes, were sitting in chairs spread throughout the property. Each one was wearing a simple rope.
Watch that tongue of yours, old man. It might go missing. Can't count on no one around here. Better get to it. See what happens when you don't listen to me? We are head first in a cropper because of you. Damn kids. Where'd they go?
Look,
sorry about your friend, but I'm afraid you done landed square dab in the shit house.
Do they get now?
Yeah.
mutations continue to plague the quiet farming communities of Central Texas, as two more were reported just last evening. The cows were discovered with the throat slit and cut from belly to hip. Officials believe multiple perpetrators are responsible, as the mutilations appear to have been committed at the same time. The Sheriff's Department advises all ranchers to patrol their property, heavily armed, and report any suspicious activity. Local farmer Devereaux Lateague told local reporters that he believes it is the work of, quote, devil worshippers. Authorities have not yet responded for comment on that claim. Residents of Marfa, Texas, say the phenomenon, simply known as the Marfa ghost lights, are occurring at an astounding rate over the last few months.
It's too foggy.
Violent man. I knew you were around here somewhere. I can't hear nothing.
Thank you.
Just get back here. You're only making things worse.
Hey, you okay?
You better not be messing with Grandpa.
Details have emerged in the grisly string of murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72. Known only as the Terror of I-40, authorities say an unidentified woman spent years hitchhiking from Texas to California, where she viciously murdered several truck drivers and three other young women along the route. Billy Jasper of Winslow, Arizona, claims he likely had an encounter with the assailant at his home over a year ago. Jasper says a young woman in 20s approached his home seeking water and food, but after a few minutes, the woman allegedly became irate with Mr. Jasper's line of questioning. Eventually, the unidentified.
There'll be lots of meat tonight.
Yeah, good meat.
Somebody around here has to catch him. You'll never see this. It always works. You ever had head cheese? It's good. Come here, I'll show you. You come out. Well, ain't you shifty? Like me. are you running?
Thank you.
attack on 3 female college students in Pflugerville, Texas last year is back in the public spotlight. Pflugerville citizens are in an uproar demanding answers from Texas state officials on why no arrests have been made in the case. Reports say an unidentified man entered the home in the middle of the night, viciously strangling one female to death before attempting to stab both roommates who were sleeping nearby. Authorities believe the attacker fled the scene after discovering multiple people lived in the house. The man is believed to be in his late 20s, has dark hair and brown eyes, and has several scars on his face and arms. Police are urging anyone with information to please come forward. 3 adolescent vandals have been terrorizing the city of Lexington, Texas, with horrific depictions of famine and the macabre. Nearby action on...
Couldn't have gone much further.
Can't focus. Need to clear my head. You think this is a party? Stop your messing around!
Kids, where'd they go?
Ha ha ha.
of this nonsense. Why is this on me to fix?
Here.